Within the Benelux, KBC Securities has been playing a leading role in almost all of the biotech businesses currently listed on Euronext Brussels.
The biotech sector is for Euronext Brussels very important. We had three IPOs. Two of those were biotech companies, Argenix and Genticel. For KBC Securities, which is the broker of KBC Group, the sector is thus very important for us, and we have developed a specific competence in this area. We have a large client base, both in Belgium, Europe and the United States, of specific biotech investors, and we take companies once to two times a year to these clients. We also host one or two specific biotech investor conferences to keep the attention of the investor focused.
In most cases, seed and risk capital investments secure the financing of the first 5 to 7 years of a company. During this time, a technology platform or idea is developed into a tangible concept.
At the startup, the companies will typically seek financing from private investors and venture capitalists. We're talking about a few 10 millions of euros. However, when the company is successful and needs to do bigger studies, they will typically opt for an IPO. The IPO allows existing investors to take profit, but more importantly, new investors can join the company. As an example, in the summer of 2014, Ablings raised an additional 40 million from the market based on good clinical results in one of their programs. In 2015, Tygenix is expected to report results on their phase 3 study in fistula, and if successful, the company will definitely have to seek new financing to bring the company to a next step.
Most listed biotech enterprises are active in the domain of drug development or high-tech diagnostics. These kinds of projects carry significant risk, but at the same time might yield a very interesting return on investment.
The approval of a new product, the positive results of a clinical study can have a big impact on the stock market of these companies. 30, 40, 50% on one day are not excluded. Moreover, analysis has shown that successful biotech companies often get acquired for huge premiums by big pharma or big diagnostic companies. And that's very attractive for investors.